Okay, now let's try and solve a differential equation with a discontinuous inhomogeneous term. A differential equation is x double dot plus 3x dot plus 2x equals 1 minus u sub 1 of t. The right-hand side makes use of the Heaviside step function. So when t is less than 1, the right-hand side is 1. It's a constant. And then when t is greater than 1, the right-hand side becomes 0. So if you view the right-hand side as a force being applied, then this is a force that is a constant force up until t equals 1, and then the force disappears. Okay, we have some initial conditions here that we start at x of 0 equals 0, and x dot of 0 equals 0. So the initial force then is causing this object to move with some velocity, and then you release the force. So this is an ideal problem to use the Laplace transform method because the right-hand side is discontinuous. So let's go to the table and then apply the table to take the Laplace transform of this equation. Okay, so we're taking the Laplace transform of x double dot. So we'll use line 16. Here, x of 0 and x dot of 0 is 0. So we'll obtain s squared times capital X plus 3 times the Laplace transform of x dot. So we'll have plus 3 times s times capital X from line 15. Again, x of 0 equals 0. Plus 2 times the Laplace transform of x. And that's going to be equal to the Laplace transform of 1. We can get that from line 2. That will be 1 over s. Minus the Laplace transform of u1 of t. We can get that from line 12 with c equals 1. That would be e to the minus s divided by s. So here we have the Laplace transform of the equation. We can now factor out an x and solve for x. So we get x equals, and then we have a 1 minus e to the minus s, divided by s squared plus 3s plus 2. But you can see that s squared plus 3s plus 2 is factorable by s plus 1 times s plus 2. Okay. This looks like a somewhat complicated expression. We can make it a little bit easier to understand if we define a function f. So let's define capital F of s to be this 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 2. Then this function here then becomes x of s is equal to f of s minus e to the minus s times f of s. Okay, when you put it in this form, we can make use of the table to take the Laplace, the inverse Laplace transform of this expression. Remember that we're going to write now the inverse Laplace transform of capital F of s is little f of t, and that will require taking the inverse Laplace transform of this 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 2. So let's have another look at the table. Here, if we want to take the inverse Laplace transform of e to the minus s times f of s, we need to make use of line 13. So we have an e to the minus cs times f of s. So here c is equal to 1. So that will become u sub 1 of t times f of t minus 1. Okay, so we've taken the Laplace transform of x of s and show that it's equal to f of t minus the Heaviside step function u1 of t times f of t minus 1. You might remember that this is a shifted function. It's a function of f of t shifted to the right by 1 unit. Okay, so this is our form of x of t. It's very, the Laplace transform method is very nice in that we get a very clean form for the solution. The only problem now is we have to take the Laplace transform of capital F of s. So let's try and do that. So we're going to write the inverse Laplace transform of, we want this one, right? That's what we're looking for. To get that one, we need to write 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 2 as a partial fraction expansion. So it would be a over s plus b over s plus 1 plus c over s plus 2. Okay. These type of partial fractions are not that difficult to do. There's a method called the cover-up method, which is quite slick, actually. What you do is to determine A, say, you multiply both sides of this equation by S, and then set S equal to 0. So if we multiply the left by S, you know, we cancel the s in the denominator. We set s equal to 0. The left-hand side will become 1 over 1 times 2, or 1 half. The right-hand side with s equal to 0 will become a, and then the b and c term will go to 0. So using that cover-up method, we can get a equal to 1 half very quickly. Let me see if you didn't quite follow that. I'll do it again. To find b, we multiply both sides of this expression by s plus 1. So the s plus 1 will cancel. The s plus 1 will cancel. And then we set s equal to minus 1. So the a and the c will become 0 because they're multiplied by s plus 1. So we have 1 over minus 1 times 1, which is negative 1, and that will be c. So b is equal to minus 1. Finally, to determine c, we multiply both sides of this equation by s plus 2 and set s equal to minus 2. And we'll get 1 over minus 2 times minus 1, which is 1 half. So BC will be 1 half. Okay. Now we have A, B, and C. So we want to take the inverse Laplace transform of this. And to do that, we should go to the tables. Okay. So we want to take the inverse Laplace transform of A over S. We'll use line 2. So that will just be A over S will have an inverse Laplace transform of A. A is a half. We want to take the inverse Laplace transform of B over S plus 1. We'll go to line 3. here 1 over s minus a, so a will be negative 1, and we'll end up with b times e to the minus t. Here b is equal to negative 1. Finally, we want to take the inverse Laplace transform of c over s plus 2. Again, from line 3, a is equal to minus 2, so we'll end up with c times e to the minus 2t, and here c is equal to 1/2. Okay, having taken the inverse Laplace transform here, putting in the values of a, b, and c, we've got the inverse Laplace transform of f of s, this is our f of t, is given by 1/2 minus e to the minus t plus 1/2 e to the minus 2t. So our solution then is x of t equals f of t, which is this expression, minus u sub 1 of t times f of t minus 1, where this expression, everywhere you see t, you replace by t minus 1. A little bit complicated, but we end up with this very nice form for x of t and then a solution for f of t. So let me review. We're trying to solve a second-order differential equation where the inhomogeneous term takes the value of 1 until t equals 1, after which it takes the value of 0. So this is a function then which is a step-down function. The initial conditions are homogeneous in that x of 0 equals x dot of 0 equals 0. We take the Laplace transform of the equation, including the Laplace transform of the Heaviside step function, and we get a solution for capital X of s, which contains this exponential function. We define capital F of s to be this fraction here, and then we can have X of s in terms of capital F of s, which we can use the table then to take the inverse Laplace transform and get this very clean expression for x of t. So x of t equals f of t minus the Heaviside step function at 1 times f of t minus 1, which is a shifted function. What remains then is to do the inverse Laplace transform of f of s. We do a partial fraction expansion and then use the cover-up method to find the unknown parameters, and then use the table to take the inverse Laplace transform. You need to practice. This is not particularly easy. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.